Hey everyone, Demonic Review Spot here, and today is Tuesday, January 18th of 2011, and I have here Little Big Planet 2 Collector's Edition for the PlayStation 3 console, which I will be unboxing shortly. But before I unbox this, I just want to mention that I was never a fan of the first Little Big Planet game, but I did play the demo of LBP 1 and 2, and I still didn't find it all that appealing, even with all the commotion about it. So it did take quite a bit of convincing for me to buy the sequel. And what convinced me the most was most of the videos that I seen on YouTube of the beta version, and I seen some pretty cool stuff that people created. For example, someone made a Sonic the Hedgehog stage, someone made a Mario Brothers level, and one that really stood out to me was that someone made a fighting game where you could have Sony characters versus Marvel versus Capcom, and I thought that was pretty cool. So, much like the first game, you can pretty much create anything you want, but they give you so much more tools to work with this time around. And I think because of all that, that convinced me the most to buy Little Big Planet 2. So with all that said, let's get on to the box. You can see it says Little Big Planet 2 Collector's Edition. I love video games, and I love collecting, so of course I picked up the Collector's Edition. And this is rated E for everyone. There you can see Sackboy holding the number 2. And up here in the corner, it does mention that it is PlayStation Move compatible. And on top of the box, says Little Big Planet 2 Collector's Edition, and you get all these costumes and avatars with it. The costumes that are included are Disney's Pixar's Toy Story 3 Alien Sackboy costume, Disney's Tron Clue Sackboy costume, The Muppets The Great Gonzo Sackboy costume, you get Ratchet & Clank Sackboy costumes, Jack and Daxter Sackboy costumes. I'm getting tired of saying Sackboy costumes, but for the rest of the costumes, you get these animal-like costumes, such as Crocodile, Vulture, Cobra, Mandrill. And, this is also supposed to include bookends and a 7-inch Sackboy plushie. So, you see in the front, you see in the top, this is the side of the box. This picture of Sackboy there with a Little Big Planet 2 logo. Nothing special. There's the back of the box. Just list all the contents included again. And there's the other side of the box. Again, nothing special. And there's the bottom of the box. Also, again, I was never a fan of the first game. So if I make a mistake or if I forgot to mention something, please put it in the comments below. All right, so let's unbox this, shall we? You can see with the Little Big Planet 2 Collector's Edition, you're getting the game, of course. There's the front of the case, and there's the back of it. You're also getting these bookends for your video games or your books, whichever you prefer to put in between those two. And I noticed these two pieces right here of these characters are made of cardboard. However, the rest of the bookends is made out of solid wood. And you're getting this 7-inch Sackboy plushie with an unzippable zipper, so that part right there cannot be pulled down. And you get this tag on him, this official licensed product of PlayStation tag, which is pretty cool. Has some awesome detail on him. So that's pretty much it. When you purchase the Collector's Edition, you're getting the Little Big Planet 2 game, the bookends, and plushie, with the exception of the DLC content, which comes with the costumes and avatars. So that's pretty much it for this unboxing video. I probably will be doing another unboxing video on February 15th when I get Marvel vs. Capcom 3, the Collector's Edition, of course, because that's one of the highly anticipated games of 2011, and I'm very excited about that game. So yeah, look out for that. If you like, rate, comment, subscribe. Once again, thank you for viewing. This is Demonic Review Spot, signing out.